Toastmasters and guests.
Good evening.
Before I begin my speech and before timer begins his time, let me just explain about the setting and what this speech is about. Now, all of you are not Toastmasters, you all are journalists, that's all I am going to see. And I am here to conduct a press conference, so I am invited to, and I am delivering my presentation now. And then I am giving an opportunity for you to ask questions. So that is the background for this. And this speech is being broadcast live, right? So there is a camera, and I might be looking into the camera and not essentially looking at you. So there could be chances that you freeze and you are disconnected, but I am connected to the audience through the camera. So that's the setting, and now I begin my speech. Welcome, journalists. It's a pleasure because you have accepted my invitation and you have come here to spend this evening. As a newly elected councillor of Rajarajeshwari Nagar, I feel it is very important for me to talk about the issues that are in the Rajarajeshwari Nagar residents' minds and explain to you the current status. Me being a resident of Rajarajeshwari Nagar, I also know what that particular issue is and how much it is bothering the residents of Rajarajeshwari Nagar. You all know, if I were to pick the topmost thing, then that issue would be garbage collection. Garbage collection has been an issue. Even for me, I have been bothered by that issue because no one comes and collects garbage from my doorsteps. After being elected as the councillor, I went to the other side of the table and did a root cause analysis, trying to find out answers and solutions for this issue. It's just been 1 month since I took up the role as a councillor. And it's very essential that I need to bring forward what is there in the system and how it is going to help the citizens. This garbage collection issue primarily is because you find that it is not being collected from your doorsteps. But let me explain, what is Bangalore City doing and what is Rajarajeshwari Nagar doing about this particular issue? In Bangalore, there are 85 lakh residents and 25 lakh households, 2.5 lakh commercial establishments. Each household is generating 1 to 1.25 kilogram of waste, solid waste. And in total, Bangalore is generating 3,500 tons of waste per day. Rajarajeshwari Nagar contributes 250 tons per day to this particular waste. Rajarajeshwari Nagar zone, when I say Rajarajeshwari Nagar, it is a zone, it includes many other areas as well. How is this 250 tons of waste being handled? We have deployed 19 trucks, 19 tractors, and 6 dumper places to transport this waste. Contractors have been engaged to do this activity. Every day, these trucks and tractors carry all this waste to the waste transit area. Earlier, this waste transit area was at Kumbalmuru, from where it was being transported to Mandur. But following Mandur's residents' agitation, BBMP established one garbage processing plant at Hemigepura, which is closer to Rajarajeshwari Nagar. This is a closed plant, that is the best advantage that we have. It's a closed plant, it does not emit any stench. It does not cause any environmental or health hazards. It's a closed plant. And it can handle 200 tons per day of solid waste, which is good enough for all the waste that the Rajarajeshwari Nagar zone is producing. And what else are we doing? The contractors have deployed power cars to collect garbage from each and every door. And these power karmikas move around, they collect the garbage, they segregate the waste into solid waste and wet waste. And this solid waste can be in the form of plastics, it can be in the form of metal, it can be in the form of paper, whatever. And these people are allowed to sell this to resellers and recyclers and make money, which will be their incentives. For each of these power karmikas, there is one road manager. This road manager monitors how this garbage collection is happening. He interacts with these power karmikas. These power karmikas make a mental calculation of how much waste they have collected in a particular day. And when they meet the road manager inquires about the collection, and if it is less, then he gets into the root cause and finds out what and why the garbage collection is less for that particular day. All these statistics in turn are analyzed in the corporation, and this helps in making a better and better system for garbage collection. Now, coming back to what we have and how we can contribute, can this system alone make this garbage management system effective? No. We need your cooperation, the citizens' cooperation. If the solid waste can be segregated at the source, then definitely this system can be very, very effective. There are many commercial establishments and apartments which already have some kind of waste segregation system which helps them. The challenge is with individual households who find it very difficult to segregate this waste. It all begins with us, and I hope if we can contribute, we can make the system very, very effective, and BBMB is there to help you. Thank you very much. I am now open to take any questions that you may have. Yes, sir.
Sir, you spoke about door-to-door garbage collection. How about placing garbage collection bins in public places and not in street corners?
Okay, that's an interesting question. Now, what happens when you place public collection garbage bins in street corners? The waste does not get segregated, and takes a lot of effort for us to segregate the waste. And even the power karmikas have to deal with the waste to kind of do that, which is wasting their time. But I appreciate, yes, the public parks are a good place to place these garbage bins, and you will find that there are categorized wastage bins where the waste is identified on the top of the bins, or color codes are used to do these bins. Yes.
Sir, what about the potholes in Rajarajeshwari Nagar? Do you have plans to fix them?
That's a question which I would like to answer in the next press conference, because it is not relevant to this. But definitely, yes, if I don't have the numbers right now, I will answer the question.
Sir, I have a concern. What about the health of workers who are working inside the garbage processing plant?
That's again a very, very concerned question, because it's concerned about the health of the workers. We also had a tough time in hiring people for this particular waste management work, because it's very difficult. But what we did was, we took them through the plant. We showed them what protective gears they would wear. We also explained them what is the protective health insurance that they have, what is the preventive health insurance that they have, and how they have been provided amenities and facilities to take bath just after their duty is done. And there are enough breaks given in between so that they can handle them. One last question, please. Yes, definitely. If the waste is segregated at source, then it makes it the power karmika's life easier. It makes the system much, much efficient and effective. Thank you. Thank you for your time.